Hey everyone, it's TAKirbyStar. In this video, I'm going to be starting my playthrough of Pokémon Shield. I'd rather not waste any time, so I'm just going to start this video. So right now, we're going to be starting with choosing the settings for the game. So like the language and my character. I'm going to pick this one right here. And I'm going to name him... let's see... Screw it, I'm going to name him Kirby. Because I don't feel like using my real name right now. Alright, you can't change languages after starting the game. Alright, yeah, let's do this. Alright. Registration complete. Welcome, one and all, welcome to the wonderful world of Pokémon. Our beloved Galar region is a wonderful place with thriving nature, beautiful cities, and many Pokémon with which we share our lives. As you know, our society is able to thrive thanks to the help of these mysterious creatures that we call Pokémon. Yes, Pokémon are all around us, in the sea, in the sky, and even with us in our towns. And those of us who choose to raise and train to do Pokémon to do battle and compete, we call Pokémon trainer. Oh, but I'm getting carried away. Please allow me to introduce myself. My name is Rose, and it's a pleasure to be here. Now turn your gaze to Galar's greatest Pokémon trainer, your undefeated champion. It's time for Champion Leon's exhibition match. Alright, wow, what a cocky show-off. Oh, never mind, he's got a Charizard. I immediately respect him now. Yeah, in case you're wondering, I'm just gonna let you know now, my favorite Pokemon is Charizard. I don't care if he's overrated, yada yada yada, yeah, fuck you, I don't care, he's awesome. I mean, he's basically a giant dragon. Oh, and now it's Gigantamaxy. Pokemon Shield. There's a Munchlax I see on the floor. Wait, so was that video we were watching on the phone? Because, like, I noticed that it looked like it was on the internet for a fast few seconds. Hello, hello! Oh, is that your flash new phone, Kirby? Were you watching Lee's exhibition match on it? But you can't cheer him on with your hands full. You know the only way to properly cheer on Lee would be with his famous Charizard pose. Pop, didn't expect to see you here today, dear. Isn't this the big day? Yeah, that's exactly why I came running over to get Kirby. Never mind watching the match now. I've got a recording at home anyway. I record all my brother's matches. Come with me, Kirby. He should be here any minute. And Lee always brings presents when he visits, so I wouldn't forget that bag if I were you. Now I've got to run. See you at mine later. Alright. Oh, I move on my own. Yeah, I was confused as to why I was not moving, so I'm gonna just talk to my mom. rushing off in that state. Kirby, didn't Hop say to bring you back? I last saw it in your room, and don't forget to grab a hat for the weather. Alright, you grabbed your dad's old bag. Adventure guide. You open the X menu by pressing the X button. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna save my game. The latest video game console is sitting by the telly. Alright, so we got a Nintendo Switch. Okay, okay. Pop is waiting for you. Better head outside. Okay. Oh, hey there, little Badu. Ha ha ha. Have a look at you, Kirby. That old bag looks like it could pull you over. But at least we now know that it can hold anything we might bring, even if it's as big as a Snorlax. A Wooloo, but what's it doing there? Hey, you silly Wooloo, I see what you're up to. Don't go using tackle on the fencing. Now you listen, no going past that fence. No, everyone knows there are scary Pokemon living in the slumbering weald. Now that that's taken care of, how about it, Kirby? Let's race. Bet I can make it to my house first. What with you and lugging about that old bag? The power of science is amazing. Now you can battle and trade Pokemon with other people just by walking around. Isn't that super amazing? I guess. Hey, Kirby, Hop was looking for you, you know. But no need to go to the next town to find him when he lives next door, right? Alright, wait, do I press the A button? Okay. Mom, is he here? There you are at last, Hop. Oh, and you brought along Kirby. Hello, dear. Yeah, but where's Lee? You got him crammed in a cupboard? I doubt it, considering how tall I saw he was. Yeah, he was tall. He's still not here yet, for the 100th time. Honestly, Hop, you must learn some patience. He's probably only just arrived at the station at Wedgehurst. Then that's where I'm going. You know Lee is hopeless with directions. I'll make sure he doesn't get lost along the way. Oh, will you? Yes, that probably is for the best. You've got to come with, Kirby. You still never met my big bro, right? You can't miss out on your chance to meet the undefeated champion. I'll wait for you out on the route. Oh, there's a purloin. Hello. To Hop, his brother is a superhero. Alright, I'm gonna just walk around his house without his consent. These sheets are very wrinkled. Oh, I see he has a Nintendo Switch too. Yeah, he's a man of culture, I see. And I assume this is... It's a perfectly made bed. It doesn't seem to have been used for a long time. Yeah, I think this is Leon's bed. Alright. Guess it's time to go to town. Quite literally, I might add. Let's get a move on. Only remember, Kirby, wild Pokemon can come out of nowhere if you walk through patches of tall grass. I've got my Wooloo with me, so I'm ready for battle against wild Pokemon, but not you, Kirby, so we'll steer clear of the tall grass as we go. So this is Wedgehurst. Hello, hello, Wedgehurst, your champion Leon is back. I promise I'll keep doing my best to deliver the greatest battles for you all to watch. It's our unbeatable champion, Leon. You and Charizard are the greatest. Well, thank you for that. I hope you'll all carry on training up your Pokémon and are never shy from battle. Then come challenge me for the champion title. We're on it. We've all been working on our battle skills, just like you taught us to, Lee. Alright then. That Charizard of yours is too strong for the likes of us to take on. I mean, yeah. Too true that Charizard is blazingly strong, but other Pokémon can be strong as well. I mean, yeah, he's right. That's why I want the strongest of challengers to fill the gym challenge and come battle me. My wish is for Galar's trainers to work together to become the strongest in all the world. Lee. Hot. So my number one fan in all the world has come out of his way to pick me up. Look at you, Hop. I reckon you've grown exactly an inch and a quarter since the last time I saw you. Bingo, that's the sort of sharp eye that's kept you undefeated for so long, eh, Lee? Could someone explain how the hell he knows that it's an inch and a quarter? And these bright eyes over here. Yeah, could someone please explain that to me? I've got it, you must be Kirby, am I right? I've heard loads about you from my little brother. I'm the Galar region's greatest champion ever, and a massive Charizard fan too. Gee, how I couldn't tell before that you were a Charizard fan, especially because your signature Pokemon was a Charizard. Yeah. Come on, Lee, you and you, Kirby. Never mind. I accidentally pressed it. With a proper rival of his own, I bet he'd push himself to become something truly special. Is that foreshadowing, I hear? Well, everyone, I bid you farewell for today, but don't you fret. I'll always be around to make sure everyone in Galar can have a champion time. Come on, Lee, you promised us a present, so out with it. You brought Kirby and me Pokemon. You did, didn't you? I know you must have. Right then. The greatest gift from the greatest champion. It's showtime, everyone. Take a good look, you two. The grass-type Pokemon, Grookey. The fire-type Pokemon, Scorbunny. And the water-type Pokémon, Sobble. Alright, yeah, they having a good time. Yeah, I see that. No, he's scared. No, don't be scared. No, oh, not Sabo. No. All right, line up, everyone. Which will you choose? Go on, you pick first. I've already got my Wooloo after all. Well, don't mind if I do. Okay. Alright, I'm not gonna stress over this. I've already made my decision. And I'm going to pick The crybaby lizard, Sobble. Yeah. That's the water type, Sobble. It adapts to anything, as surely as water flows. Going with the water type Pokemon, Sobble? You chose Sobble. Would you like to give Sobble a nickname? No, I'm not that type of person. Sobble has been added to your party. Alright, yeah, let's do this. Yeah, I like this. I like Sobble the most. It'll be Sobble for you, yeah. Yeah, out of all the Galarian starters, yeah, Sobble's probably my favorite. Yeah. Hashtag Sobble Squad, am I right? I'm aiming to be the next champion, so be ready. You and I'll be doing some serious training. But cheap. I bet you will, B-Hop. And that's why I brought along these Pokemon for you today, so the two of you can train and grow stronger together to try and reach me. Yeah, but where's Grookey? He's got nowhere to go. And you'll come with me. Charizard will show you the ropes. He's strict, but he's real strong and real kind, too. Alright, enough of this trainer nonsense for one night. Dinner's ready, children. Bring along your Pokemon and let's all eat. You know how they refer to all of them as children? Wait, did they refer to all of them as children? If so, how old is Dion? The next day. Yeah, is that a fledgling weather vane? You spent the whole night with that new partner of yours, right, Hop? You two getting on alright? Understanding one another? Maybe even built up a little bit of love? Of course I have, Lee. Kirby's made fast friends with his Sobble, too. Then listen up, new trainers. I believe in yourself and your Pokemon. If you trust one another and carry on battling side by side long enough, then someday you might become worthy rivals for me, the unbeatable champion. What are you looking at him for, Lee? I'm the one who will be coming to challenge you. If you think Kirby might be able to challenge you, then I guess he's my first rival. Yup, told you what I say, foreshadowing. But I'm not planning to lose to him and miss out on my chance to beat the unbeatable champion. Just having a Pokemon with you doesn't make you a real trainer, you know. Okay, and proper trainers raise their Pokemon up to be first rate in battle, too. Oh, and you think you're worthy of calling yourself a proper trainer already, Hop? I guess I'll be the judge of that. Let's see how you handle yourself in a battle against your friend. If he's up for it, what do you say? Willing and ready to take Hop on in the first ever Pokemon battle of your life? Oh hell yeah, I am ready. I'm gonna kick his ass. I'm gonna kick his ass into next Tuesday. Do those two things. I missed it. I accidentally pressed it. I've gotta stop accidentally pressing the A button during dialogue. Yeah. Looks like everyone's on board. Pokemon and trainers alike? Then let's do this. Alright. Blah, 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 blah. Alright. I know exactly what I need to do in order to win. Oh, do you now? Alright, yeah, you're about to get murked. Pokemon trainer hops in on Wooloo. Alright, yeah, finally we get to actually have a Pokemon battle after like 20 minutes. Yeah, it's almost been 20 minutes. How? Yeah, I'm looking at the recording time right now on OBS, and it's already been, like, almost 20 minutes. Alright, Sobble used Pound, I guess. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. Wait, whoa, that did a lot of damage. A critical hit. A critical hit? What kind of beginner's luck is that? Yeah, I know, right? The opposing ruler used Tackle. Okay. Yeah, I know. Like, yeah, how'd I get lucky with that critical hit? Like, the first move I do in the entire game is a crit. Yeah. The opposing Wooloo used Tackle. Okay, yeah. It's only doing, like, 3 damage. Yeah, I'm so scared of a sheep. Alright. Sobble grew to level 6. Okay, then. Sobble learned Water Gun. Oh, hell yeah, he's gonna get destroyed. It's not over yet, I've added another trusty ally to my team. Also, I just realized something. Hop is probably the first Pokemon rival in the entire main series to have, more than one Pokemon when starting out. Alright, yeah, see, we're gonna destroy this kid. And the bunny. Did you already know about type advantages? Well, it's his fault he picked the one that's weaker. He picked the type that's weaker to mine. Yeah, it's rock, paper, scissors, and you lost. Yeah, I picked scissors, he chose rock. Wait, actually, hold up. Wait, no, rock beat scissors. Hold up, never mind. You beat my two Pokemon with your one? You and that Sobble are too much. Well, that was a shock. Guess I now know why Lee thought that he should give you a Pokemon too. I mean, yeah, how else are we gonna start the game? Dumbass. You and your Pokemon all fought hard. Made me almost want to let out Charizard and join in on all the fun. I mean, yeah, don't do that. It's probably like a really high level and we're only in the single digits. Don't. Arceus, please no. And Kirby, you've got real promise. In fact, I've got a favor to ask you. Be a real rival to Hop. Would you push him and make the both of you stronger? I already want to get stronger and stronger. You see me battle now, Lee, so come on. You've got to let me take on the Pokemon gyms. You join the gym challenge? You think you're ready for the single greatest competition in the Galar region? Not putting the cart before the Rapidash there, little brother. I mean, yeah. If that's really what you want to do, you two have a whole lot you need to learn about Pokemon. Well, I'm all set, because I know a lot about Pokemon. Especially your friend Kirby. Before you think about getting gym badges, best thing about getting a Pokedex. A trainer's Pokedex helps them learn lots of things, including about all the Pokemon out there, including their strengths. But it's more than just a collection of data. You need to know. It's a record of a trainer's love and passion for Pokemon training. Right. We get it. Pokedexes then. We're on it. The hell is that pose? Like, what? Looks like it's off to the Pokemon Research Lab. That's the kind of enthusiasm a trainer needs. I'll let the professor know to expect. If I'm going to be the next champion, so completing a single Pokedex will be nothing. Oh, you've got no idea. Yeah, I'm going to tell you now. Yeah, completing the Pokedex is probably the hardest thing to do in a Pokemon game. Like, look. Yeah. How naive, Bob. How goddamn naive. Crash. Kirby, did you hear that just now? And the gates opened, and that Wooloo was there. God damn it, Wooloo. Hop told you not to... Oh my god, he told... It was tackling the fence. And yeah, it was tackling the fence, and then I guess it broke, yeah. I remember the professor's granddaughter went in there once, and she came back in a real state. And that's nothing compared to the earful she got from the professor afterward. Kirby, what are you saying? We've got to save it. I mean, yeah, we got to do the right thing, right? Even if we're not supposed to. This is the kind of scene where you simply have to do the right thing. Yeah. Yeah, you've got to do the right thing. Yeah, we got to save the Pokemon. Yeah. Yeah, we can't let him get the shit beaten out of him by the wild Pokemon in there because he said there are scary Pokemon there. Yeah, we can't let them beat the shit out of the Wooloo. The Slumbering Weald. That Wooloo, where do you think it got off to? The fog's really coming on thick now. If we don't find that Pokemon soon, this might be trouble. You encountered a wild Swampert. Yeah, I don't feel like dealing with these, especially because I don't really have any Pokeballs. So I'll be back to deal with you guys later, I think. I don't know. Yeah, sorry if the screen looks a little bit weird, like the halves of the trees look chopped off. That's because of just the screen. Yeah, I apologize in advance. Even though it's already been 20 minutes since I started recording this. Alright, a wild Brookidee, huh? Run. Yeah, no point in fighting it if I can't catch it. And it's only level 2. Did you hear that? Was that a Pokemon crying out, you think? Another Pokemon. Another Squawbit, huh? Yeah, these two the only Pokemon I see? Yeah, run. Come on, Kirby, that Wooloo might be in real trouble. Alright, let's go then. Alright, we're going into the fog. It's actually kind of hurting my eyes in real life, which isn't good. Because it's all white and stuff. Yeah, it's hurting my eyes. I can't even see my own hand in front of my face. I think I get now why this place is off limits. Oh no, it's a cutscene. Ow, ow, son of a bitch, my eye. Ooh, look a dog. What in the? Alright then. Question mark appeared. Oh no, it's a box art legendary Pokemon. Alright, let's fight it then. We're gonna beat the shit out of him. Water gun. But the move has no effect? The mysterious Pokemon's gaze is fixed on you. What? The move had no effect on it. Stubble used water gun again. Let's see if it does something different. Okay. The move has no effect. Kirby, I can't see anything. You okay? Alright, so I'm gonna use water gun. Oh dear, we're getting swallowed up by the fog. I can't see anything. Wah! Ha! Kirby! What, Lee? How'd you manage to find your way here? You're pants with directions. You always get lost. Oh, that's nice to hear. Okay, wait, I'd been waiting ages for you two, and you never showed. Of course I came looking for the both of you. Wait, where's the Wooloo? We were trying to rescue that Wooloo. Yay, we saved it, even though he did. The little chap's just fine, though all of you had fainted by the time I found you here. You know this place is out of bounds, but it took some courage to come in here all the same, and I can understand well enough why you did it. You did good, huh? At least we know that Wooloo's alright. Yeah, Kirby, I thought we'd had it when that weird fog started rolling into that mad Pokemon attack. But at least it wasn't all for nothing. Attacked by some mad Pokemon? What are you talking about, Hop? It seemed loads stronger than any Pokemon I've ever seen. It just had this sort of presence. Our moves didn't touch it. I mean, really. But it seemed to pass right through it. Your moves passed through it. So the fearsome Pokemon they say live in the slumbering wild, are they actually illusions or something? Get strong enough and maybe the two of you can... if it wants to reveal the truth someday. For now, let's simply get out of this place. You'll be alright now that I'm here with you. Yeah, we'll be safe from all the level 2 Pokemon. Even if we did get an earful from Lee, what an experience! This will make a pretty fine first page in my tale of legend. Alright then. Don't forget to tell your mom we're off to Wedgehurst now. She'll go spare if you leave without a word, even worse than Lee just did. Alright then. Alright, let's go to the house. And I see a second Badoo join the other Badoo. Well, now, isn't Sobble just a sweetheart? I mean, yeah, I guess. Yeah, it's adorable as shit. And yes, I've heard the news from young Leon. I'm glad someone bothered to tell me. Off to Wedgehurst, aren't you? Here we are, a bit of pocket money for your journey. Buy yourself a little something at the Pokémon Center, maybe some potions or something. Remember that Sobble will battle to the very end for you, so don't go pushing the poor deer too hard. And you, Sobble, look after my little Kirby. Hold on, wait. How tall is Sobble anyway? Because it's probably shorter than Kirby actually is. Alright, hold on. Okay, just looked it up. He's a foot tall, so he's about 4 inches taller than Kirby is. It just goes to show how short Kirby really is. Yeah, he's only 8 inches tall. Come home to rest anytime that you need. After all, east or west, home is best. Alright then. Okay. And this is where I plan to stop this video.
I think it's gonna just about to end this video. Now, if Kirby sent you at the beginning of the video, if you want to help out my channel,
subscribe and turn on the notifications for my channel, and you can join the lookout for new videos of mine. Also consider joining my social media, like my Twitter, my subreddit, and my Twitch. I think there's only one thing left to say now. Bye!